The coin toss at the center field has been completed. Tulsa will receive the kick, defend the goal to your right. Weather conditions, a 30% chance of rain here today. It rained in Lawrence overnight, stopped at about noon today. The field about an hour ago seemed to be dry, a little damp. They say that will help the traction here. However, there are rain clouds on the horizon. If the rain comes in, it's going to get slippery. Whose advantage is that? There's Kerwin Bell.
Frank, I've got to believe that if it rains and gets wet down there on the field, that it's got to be an advantage to Kansas because they have the bigger of the offensive people, and Tulsa relies heavily on their speed and their quickness of their defense.
Bruce Kalmeyer to kick off. He is an excellent kicker for Kansas. And back deep, May and Lacey. Line drive into the end zone, no return. There's your backfield. Skip Ast, the running back, Michael Gunter, averaging 9.3 yards per carry, three touchdowns this year. The fullback, Ken Lacey. At split end, Kirk Phillips, and at flanker, Keith Estes. John Green, the starting flanker, will not play today. Estes to the near side. Phillips flanked out to the top of your screen. Here comes Gunter. Is 9, and he got 12. 10 Tulsa, the ball at the 32. The defensive line for Kansas. Walter Parrish is a key player, that nose guard, 61. The linebackers, Mike Arbanis, yes, he is the son of Fred Arbanis. Motion this time by Estes. The quick hitter up the middle. That'll be good. For 4 yards.
Put him in an even defense, and I believe that Skip Ast is going to be asked to audible into that, and I think that's...
He will be able to explain a lot of the rule changes and penalties for us today. First down. Gunter that time piled up. He may have gotten a yard. Eddie Simmons, the starting right linebacker, came up to force the play. Again, motion by the tight end, Steinhauer. Uh-oh. Now, the question, were they drawn off sides or did they just jump?
Well, you had movement in the backfield. Number 22, Michael Gunther, moved. So, it's up to the ref.
It's against Kansas for jumping. The split backfield behind Ast. The quick hitter up the middle, this time it's Lacey and Parrish on the stop. With the option game and this veer attack, they can get the yardage they need. The pitch this time, this is Lacey. Tried to turn it and got some yardage. He's inside the 35 at the 32-yard line. Third down, 4 yards to go. This is a big play for Tulsa. I believe Ast got it back, but that'll bring up fourth down. Parkey Alexander was in on the play. Decided not to go for the field goal. The drive stops at the 36-yard line. Going for the corner. And it's into the end zone for a touchback. So Tulsa drives the ball down the field from their own 20 down to the Kansas 36. But they had to punt the ball away, and Kansas has the ball for the first time today. There's Frank Sire, the quarterback, an excellent one, all Big 8 last year. The I formation behind him, E.J. Jones and Dino Bell. Play action fake, he's going up right away. And a drop. When he comes back to the huddle after just dropping a pass.
Well, generally, so early in the ball game, I wouldn't say anything. I mean, it was the first pass thrown to him. Both the quarterback and the receiver are tight. So I wouldn't say anything, Frank.
Here's the offensive line, a big offensive line for Kansas. Tulsa's defensive people are worried about that, especially if it rains. They've got to handle them with quickness. Dino Bell, again, is the starting halfback. Big brother Kerwin waits in the wings. Again, play action fake. Sire will run. Look at the straight arm. First down, 11 yards on the carry. Bob Babich ran him out of bounds. First and 10, this time from the 31-yard line. There's his rushing yardage, so that 11-yard gain was way above that. D'Lo Bell gets the call. Uh-oh. Meet Brian Bruner. He and the two linebackers behind him, Bob Babich and Cliff Abbott. There's the defensive line. They will switch up a lot today, Tulsa, with its defense. There is Kerwin Bell into the ballgame for the first time. Number four, he is the deep back. They're behind E.J. Jones. He gets the call and gets hit. Yesterday, during the Kansas practice, I had an opportunity to talk to Kerwin Bell about the fact that he's coming back from a ligament injury, coming back after a year away from football. I asked him, when would the butterflies start?
I'm not quite sure. I haven't felt that much pressure myself. You know, it doesn't seem like it's been that long. I mean, I feel like I've been in the season all the way after I was hurting up to now. And I think that may start tomorrow, but I think it'll really be when I first step on the field. That's when I think I will feel it.
Third down and 15. Sire must pass. His man, 86. Garfield Taylor makes the reception, but it's not enough. Kerwin Bell is out. He's still got to feel the butterflies, Dennis.
He certainly does. He's only been in for one offensive play. But Garfield Taylor, who made that reception, was the leading rusher on the football team last year with 728 yards. So he's been in there before.
Bucky Scribner, the kick. Oh, he boomed it. Look at it. Bounces at the goal line and into the end zone for a touchback. Scribner, a tremendous punter, got one off that time, 63 yards. Tulsa starts again where it had the ball before, at their own 20-yard line. Again, it's the tight end who shifts sides of the field. The quick hitter up the middle, Lacey. 8 yards and two for Tulsa. Again, the quick hitter. Again, it's Lacey on the carry. He's got the first down. Kansas says the officials will decide. Once they get everybody unwrapped there, that's a tangle.
Frank, we've seen Tulsa now on the first two plays of this series run that inside veer. That's the play that they want to run. They know they have to run it in order to be effective offensively. Kansas, on the other hand, has got to make that adjustment inside. You can see it right here. The quarterback reverse turns, hands the ball off on the inside veer. They get good blocking, but the ball was loose.
Pass number two, and again, it's dropped. This time the intended officials today, as we said, John McClintock, the referee from the Big Eight. Motion against Tulsa. First down and 15 from their own 30. A familiar split back field. Lacey again. He got the 5 yards of the penalty back. Ed Simmons on the season, and a touchdown. His longest run has been 20 yards. He's up over the 50-yard mark now in this game already. Here he goes again. 4 yards on the carry.
Because of the heat out here, I believe it's dried up.
Third down, a long 5 yards for Tulsa.
You could see there the Skip Ast, who's not
Bearcat. Taken. Kansas will get the football back in fairly decent field position. First and 10 from their own 28 after a 33-yard punt.
Hope not.
Look at this. Pittsburgh came back. West Virginia had them down 13-0. And LSU is pulling off the upset of the day. First and 10 for Kansas. It's Kerwin Bell back in the ball game. With the ball, and again, for the second time today, he loses yardage. His freshman year alone, he rushed for 1,114 yards. Again, the I formation for Kansas. That time he made yardage. Team situation. Capers out to the far side. Johnson to the near. Slipped. Wet surface probably at that end of the field, I would guess. That's a sure sign of it. Kevin Lilly covered. Is Brent Davis for Tampa. Here's Bucky Scribner. 62-yard punt, his first punt of the day. That's his longest this year. On a fair catch by the up back, Tulsa will take over with the best field position they've had all day at their own 33. Gunner. It's a tough 4 yards. Simmons and Gentry combine to make the tackle. One receiver wide to the far side, the top of your screen, 87 Keith Estes. Two tight ends in the ball game now. They go with Lacy. Dennis Lacy has found a great deal of success here early in the ball game.
That Skip Ash just hands the ball off to Lacy, but look at the line blocking up front, 79, 58, Sid Abramowitz.
With 8 carries for 47 yards. First and 10, Tulsa, the 46. Who gets the quick hitter up the middle. Ed Simmons on the stop.
Blocks of the offensive lineman very well, and that oftentimes makes the lineman look better than the block.
Again, look at the two tight end formation. That time the fake and the keeper. Asked. No gain. They wrap that up in a hurry. The offensive coordinator, the next play they want. Again, they go two tight ends. Again, the wide receiver is out of your picture at the top of the screen. Lacy, big haul. A step away from breaking it. Elvis Patterson more cross-body blocked him than tackled him. Looking off to the left as he got through the hole and he saw it develop. AC out of the ball game. Play action fake. Complete. Johnny Horton with the first reception of the day. First completion in 4 attempts. For second and 1 from the Kansas 28. AC fumbles the football. Picked up by Kansas. Bell in the ballgame. First and 10 from the Kansas 20-yard line. Motion. Led the nation in turnover ratio. They got the ball back more than they gave it away. This year it hasn't been that good. First down, 15. Fumble. Sire will get out of trouble. Second down and 9. Possibly 4 yards of a carry.
Bring that ball into your stomach. They call it the third pocket.
All right. It's third down now. 5 yards to go for Kansas. Sire looking. Wide open. Capers. Estel. He's wide out here to the near side. He's out of your picture. E.J. Jones, the big fullback, bruises it out to the 40-yard line. Gain of 4. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Now they're making first downs, picking up first downs, and moving the football. Real important series.
Again, the big carry. Jones, first down. Kansas is moving the football. Cooper. That they've mounted. Whistle stop the play. A tie there with Georgia. Herschel Walker injured. Sire again trying to pass. Good protection. Capers with a nice comeback pattern. Complete. Mark it at the 30, make it the 24-yard line at the end of the first quarter. Kansas with its deepest penetration into Tulsa territory in this first quarter.
This is a big play set up totally by Sire and Capers. What Capers does here, Sire will abide for more time, running around, looking for Capers. Capers comes back to the ball, gets a good throw, big play.
He's coached twice as the head coach. First down. Is trying it up the middle. Charles Cooper on the carry as E.J. Jones.
It's finally come to life here early in the second quarter, and it's in good field position to score.
Fumble. Loose ball. Tulsa has it.
Turnovers.
Believe me, that won't make Coach Don Fambro very happy.
The Tulsa coaches are delighted. There's John Cooper. He says his priorities for a football team are number one, defense, number two, the kicking game, and number three, the offense. First and 10. There's that quick hitter again. And again, Lacey gets good yardage.
To the side of the strength to stop the outside veer. But thus far, they've been ineffective.
This time, the pitch. And again, you can see it's a little slippery down on that part of the field. Gunner lost his footing.
And it's not.
It's third down and four. Lacey, again, and I think he's close to the first down.
That's true, and you got to give Lacey a lot of credit because he's made some. Lacey's made some great cuts off of off their blocks, and that's the reason why he's got 67 yards so far.
Steve Cook to punt for Tulsa, averaging 40 yards per kick. Back deep for Kansas, Darren Green. Low kick. Green's going to return it. Oh, look at the hole! Look at the hole! He's gone.
Just cuts right up the middle, and there was nothing there but speed and a bunch of blue sky. He just ran like the wind.
Look at him wave.
76 yards.
Waving the wheat. Darren Green with a 76-yard punt return for a touchdown. Maybe that will bring this Kansas team alive. The extra point. It's Parents' Day, and Darren Green's parents from Long Lead on a 76-yard punt return. It's Kansas by 7.
Take a look here. Darren Green, number 22. He does himself a lot of good. He makes that move to the outside like he's going outside. All the Tulsa people go to the outside. The key block there on number 11. And after that, it was nothing but his sure speed. And nobody comes even close to Darren Green.
Here comes Crum's kickoff now as Kansas with a 7-0 lead. I want to talk to you a moment about who had the lead first in this ball game and how important it is. On the near side is May, and on the far side is Phillips. It will be Phillips to take the ball at the 3. To the 23.
Lead, they can sit on it and they can control the clock and the progression of the game.
Again, it's Lacey, and again, it's a good hole.
Number 5.
5 yards. Ask looks it over. 2nd and 5. Johnny Horton is in the backfield now with Lacey. It's to Horton, and it's incomplete. Ask has only hit on 1 of 5 pass attempts today. 3rd down. 5 yards to go for Tulsa. Mark him out just beyond the 31. Ed Simmons knocked him out of bounds. Again, about a half yard short of a first down, it would appear. And the man who just ran 76 yards for a score waits. A high kick this time. There'll be no return. You'll have to fair catch it. Well, the Kansas fans want a penalty because he was touched. He wasn't hit. So Kansas takes over. Picnic and relax, enjoy yourself, and see virtually all. And it looks like we've got the makings of a gorgeous day here, Lawrence. First and 10 for Kansas. They've got the lead at 7-0. Sire wants more. Capers. Oh, he dropped it. Last week, Kentucky. At halftime, Brent Musburger, total 114 yards offense so far in the game. 83 for Tulsa. Again, incomplete. Two brought in the play. He he's flanked out to the bottom of the screen, out of the top. Capers. He's coming in motion now. Three wide receivers out in the pattern. Intended for Capers and picked off. Timmy Gibbs.
Sire should not have thrown this football. Capers was covered very well. You could see it right there. It was a great great interception by Timmy Gibbs, number 23. There he is.
Passed on a keeper. Almost. He's number 16. 22 is Michael Gunner. They're in the backfield for Tulsa. Gunner, good run. Close to the first down, Jay Kane. He says he's the most nervous man in Kansas today. Asked on the sneak, and I think he's got the first down. I'd like to hear that, what he's telling them.
I would if I was on the sideline.
Oh, Kansas man gets back. The pitch to Gunner. Beautiful block. Almost another first down. 8 yards on the carry. Second down and three. Again, it's Gunner. Good tackle that time. Defensive left tackle Broderick Thompson has been taken to the hospital for precautionary x-rays. He could be back for the second half. Something wrong with his shin. The quick hitter. And again, it's a first down. This time, Eddie Hamilton. Johnny Horton has come into the Tulsa backfield, along with Eddie Hamilton. They are the backup running backs.
Could have picked up at least a first down and possibly could have scored.
Michael Gunner's back in the ballgame. Here comes Eddie Hamilton. Mike Arbanis on the stop. Ed Simmons, a Kansas linebacker, has come back into the game. But now a timeout. Timeout has been called by the Kansas defense. I know some defensive players who would say,
oh, a defensive timeout or an offensive timeout.
Former West Virginia All-American Sam Huff. You've heard of him. He hated to see the defense take a timeout. Lacey, good haul. Lacey. Tulsa scores to tie this game, or a chance to.
This has the effect of a draw play. Lacey, who runs well behind good blocking, makes another good cut to the outside and just uses his speed and desire to get into the end zone.
Here's the extra point attempt. Stu Crum to kick it. We got ourselves a football game in Lawrence. Tulsa has marched right back down the field. And on Lacey's touchdown run, knotted the score. 8 minutes, 24 seconds left to go on the first half. We're all tied up in Kansas, and they've tied up this football game. Two deep backs, Darren Green and Travis Hardy for Kansas. Here's Crum's kick. Green takes it. Looking. Almost had a gap. Pushed out of bounds by Rojan. The hazards of being a kickoff man. Sometimes you kick the ball, sometimes it kicks you. First and 10 for the Jayhawks. Sire again with the eye formation. Second down. DJ Jones on the quick hitter. Charles Cooper on the quick hitter. Give him 2 yards in the carry. To the far side. Two receivers, including Capers, here to the near. On the draw. Bell. Good hole. Kerwin Bell to the 42. Albert Myers made what was the saving tackle.
Makes a big difference, Frank.
Yes, it does. First and 10, Kansas. Their own 41. Kerwin Bell again.
You
if they give him the sidelines. Clock is moving down to 6 minutes left to go here in the first half. We're tied at 7. In Tulsa territory at the 46. Luck going up the middle. We have a 7-7 tie. His 10th catch of the year, the second here in this game.
Be a hometown call, but a great throw regardless by Sire right on the sideline. Let's take a look, see if he gets 1 foot in.
Oh, yeah. I like it. 20.
Take another look. A great throw by Sire right on the sideline. Bob Johnson comes down. He certainly's got 1 foot close to being in, but I think his foot is on the line.
Sire now, 5 for 9 passing, 87 yards. At the slippery part of the field down there on the far side, 20, facing second down and 8. DJ Jones in the middle isn't there. Cliff Abbott stood him up. Got a late flag. Action could be against.
Right here at the top of your pitcher, number 43. Now watch him bump into number 80, Sylvester Byrd. Get away from me. And he gets caught, you know.
Even hit him with a flag.
Right. It wasn't his fault. He was just reacting to the other guy.
Hit him right in the leg with a flag.
But the ref caught him. And was a recruiting coach. Went out to recruit Frank Sire. And he remembered him, never forgot him, and couldn't wait to go to Kansas or go anywhere that John Hato belonged. And thank God for Kansas that Hato was from Kansas.
On third and 23, the receiver fell down. By the long field goal. He'll go for the corner. He's very good at it. Really has a good touch. Low kick. He goes the far side. The official will mark it. At the 22. Tulsa takes over there. First and 10. The 17-yard line. I beg your pardon. 83 yards.
Certainly is.
Here we go. Lacey again. A quick hitter up the middle, and Kansas can't stop it. A good position here. Faces second down, 3 yards to go. Gunner on the quick hitter that time, and they read it all away.
It's such a great start that most of the teams are pointing to stop him.
Hitter up the middle. They'll mark it at the 30-yard line. That'll be good for a Tulsa first down. The clock will stop with 3:14 left to go in the first half. A 7-7 tie. George and Jimmy the Greek Snyder. Then following it, a brand of football played every week all over America, but rarely seen on network television. Gunner on the carry. Gain of about 6. Good fake. Third down and 4. Lacey again up the middle. You want to know what kind of a day he's had? 2 minutes, 14 seconds left to play. Lacey again. President of the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, married, Skip Jr., one child. To the 45 seconds remain in the first half of this game. Reaction fake. And a good defensive play down here. Got off a good one that time. Turn it over. What does he get? Can you go for a score?
Got to go for the score. Plenty of time.
Dino Bell. Got the blockers. Knifing through there to make that tackle. Carl Pendleton, 68.
The other thing to think about, Frank, both teams have such great field goal kickers. You really only have to get down to roughly the 30-yard line, 35-yard line, and take a shot at a field goal.
Kansas has one timeout left. 46 seconds to go in the first half. Second down, 6. first down at the 35-yard. Seconds to go, and the family. Here we go. Sire, the keeper. Was that a busted play? Now he'll take his last time out.
Kelly Beasley, it must be 35 yards back off the ball. He looks like he's back for a punt.
Kansas is at their 30. He's back at the 35. Sire. Picked off again. Second interception of the day. Brent Dennis, the left quarterback, playing with a pulled hamstring. He's got an interception. So Tulsa's got the ball with 2 seconds left, and they've got time to kick it. We got a flag at the end of the play. Clip.
Not a good play by Frank Sire. We said prior to the snap that Tulsa was in a prevent defense. You can see, look how far back the defensive backs are. And number 15 from Tulsa comes up with the interception, Brent Dennis. And had it not been for the clip on the interception, Tulsa would be in excellent field goal position and possibly get another 3 points before going in at halftime. They still are going to try for the field goal.
This is going to be interesting, folks. Here goes the attempt from 63 yards. It's up. Is it long enough? No. Short and wide to the right. That'll be the final play of the first half. Kansas goes off the field. I'm sure Don Fambrough is shaking his head. Tulsa goes off the field. They're going to talk about adjustments. We'll be back with our halftime activities after a word from your local station.
Absolutely, Frank. We said at the beginning of the show that Frank Sire was very effective in moving his team between the 20s. The problem and the key for him today was to get the ball to the end zone, and thus far he's not been able to do that.
All right, you've been in that locker room at halftime before with Michigan and Bo Schembechler. You know what that atmosphere is like in the Kansas locker room, or you should be able to guess. Their number one problem is Ken Lacy. He's rushed for over 100 yards in the first half alone.
Again, we talked about Kansas would be able to move the football, but the big key was for Kansas to be able to stop Tulsa. They have not done that thus far this afternoon.
Now, the Tulsa coaches, are they happy? They pleased with what they see?
I think they have to be very pleased. Their game plan is going along as they had planned. They were interested in moving the ball via the Vera offense, and they've been able to do that.
Will they play a cat-and-mouse game, the Tulsa coaches? What I'm thinking is Lacy has been so successful in the first half. Will they anticipate that Kansas will try to adjust to that and therefore make an adjustment of their own?
Well, I really think that Lacy's been so effective up the middle that what's going to happen in the second half is that Skip Ashton is going to come out and they're going to start running that outside beer option, and you're going to see some bigger runs in the second half than you did in the first.
We have a 7-7 tie here at halftime. There's some other big scores from around the country. We'd like to show some of them to you. Passing yardage. Kansas has to be disappointed with only 87 yards through the air. But you like something else there, Dennis.
I think the turnovers are the key. Kansas is still in this football game, and they turned the ball over 3 times. That, to me, says that Kansas is playing pretty good football, but all they got to do is cut down on those turnovers, and I think they could control the second half.
The reason Kansas is in this football game after a half is because of this.
This is the real reason why Tulsa is in the football game. Ken Lacy's had just an outstanding first half. You'll see him here, number 5, cut to the outside, demonstrates his tremendous speed and determination to get the ball in the end zone here. Ken Lacy, number 5.
Said Dennis at the beginning of this broadcast that the quarterbacks might be the difference in this football game. What about it?
Made a critical error at the beginning of the second quarter when he came out and threw that interception to Kenny Gibbs, I believe it was.
You've been there. You're a good quarterback. Can he come back in the second half?
Certainly. I mean, you go into the second half, you look at what's going on defensively, and the coaches will give you some tips on how to change what you've been doing wrong in the first half. In the second half, you just come out, relax, and do what you got to do.
All right, sir. Second half still to come. We'll see if Frank Sire can bounce back. We'll be back with the second half kickoff right after these messages.
University of Tulsa. CBS Sports coverage of today's game is sponsored by Toyota, who remind you that it's a good feeling to buckle up for safety. Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by the Twin Action Norelco Rotatrack Razor.
Stu Crum prepares to kick off for the Gold Hurricane of Tulsa, wading back deep. On the far side of the field, Mims. On the near side, Darren Green. There will be no return. Out of the end zone, Kansas ball, first and 10.
This is going to come out and try for several big plays. I think.
First and 10 at the 20. Bob Johnson to the far side of the top of your screen. Out here to the near side, Wayne Capers. Bell. 2 yards at best. See what they can do here. Sire, the quarterback. Dino Bell again and slips. Capers out here to the near side, along with 22 Darren Green. Johnson flanked to the far side. He's there at the top of your screen. The draw. Dino Bell goes nowhere. He lost another yard.
I was half right.
From their own 19-yard line, Scribner must punt, and he'll have to boom one this time. He did. Long punt. Taken at the 30. Out to the 36-yard line. Half. Tulsa will have a chance right after we come back. What's Tulsa got to do here, Dennis?
Well, I think they're going to use Lacey in the second half as a decoy.
And around. It'll lose yardage.
Set up, Frank.
Carkey Alexander made the stop. Oh, movement on the offensive line, and Kansas will draw another 5 yards. David Pierce, second down and 19 for the Tulsa Gold Hurricane. Lacey in a ball game with Gunner. Play action fake. He's got all the time in the world. And we got a late flag thrown upfield. See what the call is here. The sun has come out for the first time since noon today here in Lawrence.
Asked on that last
baseball there of a walk is as good as a hit.
Tulsa defense has shut down the Jayhawk offense, and now they're moving the ball with a first down from their own 37. Lacey again, and again he gets good yardage. Updating you on Herschel Walker, there were reports of strained stomach muscles, but he's doing just fine, thank you. He's already over the 100-yard mark in Georgia's game this afternoon against Mississippi State.
What's the difference? 58 Steve Cox and 79 Sid Abramowitz.
Second and 4. Again it's Lacey, again a good hole. Again, that tight end switches sides of the field. Gunner. Uh-oh, watch out. Dennis, the Tulsa coaches must have been listening to you. They are using that option, getting outside now.
Tulsa's had so much success this afternoon.
On second down and 5. Just on the keeper. But he had a lot of things in his mind. His young wife was pregnant. She gave birth to Skip Jr. He went to work, and he came back a tremendous quarterback. I think that's the first time today Kansas has stopped that quick hitter.
He's had at the quarterback position.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Tulsa at the Kansas 38. Gunner. To the 32. It's an off day for Michael Gunner. Lacey's been doing all the running. Critical third down. Gunner again. He's got the first down. Hey, rushing yardage. First and 10. Here goes Gunner again. Second down. Called it a long 5. Gunner now is 71 yards on the day. Here he goes again. Inside the 20. Close. Coming up to play number 13 in this drive. Passed on the keeper. Did he get the first down? Don Fambrough is not happy. 7-7 tie. Tulsa threatens first and 10 at the 16-yard line of Kansas. They were bringing people that time, and they stopped it.
Happened on defense, and the only way they can do that is either bring linebackers or bring safety men on blitzes.
Two wide receivers, one out to each side. They're out of your screen. He wants it. Sack, he slipped. 15 yards to go from the 25. Looks like Ast is checking off. Dropped. Crum is 4 for 8. Up. It's good. From 42 yards. For the first time this afternoon, Tulsa has taken the lead on a 42-yard field goal from Steve Crum. 6 minutes, 17 seconds left to go in the third quarter. The Kansas defense held, but Tulsa got three. Tulsa used 6 minutes, 49 seconds. Darren Green, who had that 76-yard punt return for a touchdown, is on the near side. Robert Mims is on the far. Again, a long kick. Green will take it this time, but he won't.
Tulsa honest on defense. Be aggressive, though.
Kerwin Bell has come back into the ballgame. 35 is Charles Cooper. He's the fullback in front of Bell. Sire. Hit Kerwin Bell right in the chest. And he got decked.
Contact.
Capers is flanked out to the top of your screen. To the bottom is Johnson. Screen pass. Kerwin Bell with a nice catch there. He's got room. Gain of 5 on the play. Kerwin Bell goes out. Garfield Taylor is in the football game. Along with Cooper. Sire loads it up. He had Garfield Taylor. The line of scrimmage, the Kansas 26. 4th and 4. Caught up, we'll have a return. And swarm. Tulsa defense just off the field after holding Kansas to just 5 yards in their last possession.
Favors the run over the pass when they have the football.
To add to that, Kansas has a total of 5 yards offense in this quarter. But they figured out how to stop that quick hitter by Ken Lacy, haven't they?
For now.
Defensive coordinator Mike Knoll for Tulsa. Second down, 10 yards to go. Two wide receivers are split out here to the bottom of your screen. Lacy. Look at this. His way to 200 with a look of that run.
Reasons why Tulsa's so effective. Skip Ash that time, audible to the field, and he really made a good call because they ran away from the blitz that was coming by the Kansas defense. And number 32, Elvis Patterson, you could see him trailing the runner at the very end of the play. He was on a blitz, and Ash audibled away from it.
This time it's Gunner up the middle on the quick hitter, and it works.
And making sure that their offense was in a good play every down.
The wide receivers this time are at the top of your screen. Gunner. It just never developed there. He had civil scholarship fund of each MVP school to assist qualified students in all chosen academic disciplines. This is the 12th year of the Chevrolet Scholarship Program, and we at CBS are delighted to be a part of such a beneficial program.
Stuff like that, they come up with big plays. Otherwise, Tulsa just eats them up.
Here's the punt, and it is a gorgeous punt. Bounces at the 3 and will go into the end zone. An automatic touchback for Kansas. So once now, to the chagrin of their fans, they're down 3 to a very good Tulsa team. Trying to get the offense untracked. The defense has allowed 215 yards rushing by Lacy and Gunner so far in this football game. Sire on first down. Nobel.
Ball carrier number four.
Kerwin Bell. Second down. 8 yards to go. Dennis Ends is playing a little flat now.
I really don't think so, Frank. I think it's a combination of a couple of things. The first time they received the ball in the second half, I thought the play selection was poor. They came out and just tried to run the ball. The second time they come out and they throw the football, and two out of the three times the backs drop the football. That is an indication of being flat. Now, in this series, I think if they just settle down and do the things they know how to do best, they can get back in this football game.
Sire drops the football. A scramble. I think Tulsa's got it. That is a big play for that Tulsa defense. Who's got the ball? 57, Cliff Abbott.
That really hurts. One thing you're taught when you start running as a quarterback, you got to tuck that ball away, as do running backs. And the ball was hit out of Frank Sire's hand, and Tulsa comes up with a big turnover.
Brian Bruner, the nose guard, creates the fumble. Cliff Abbott comes up with a football. And Tulsa's got excellent field position at the 25 of Kansas. Here comes Gunner. Watch out. Ran out of room. Tulsa, second down at one. Almost a smorgasbord for an offense. Free play. Gunner kept his feet. He's got the first down by 2 yards.
But look for Tulsa this time to come to the right and go behind Sid Abramowitz.
One wide receiver way out here to the bottom of your screen is Hersey. Quick hitter Lacy to the five. Quarter of this game.
Here you can take a look. They went to the right that time, and Abramowitz and Cox made two key blocks up the middle, and that play just hit so fast. Before you know it, the running back is into the secondary, and it was another good play.
First or second down. Second down and two. On the keeper, Ast to the goal line.
Ast this time just decides to follow Lacy because there's a big hole. He gets a good block from Lacy, number five, and picks up good yardage down to the 1 yard line.
First and goal. And they try to run
over the top and pop skip Ast and stop them from scoring the touchdown.
Second and goal. Nothing there. Tulsa 10, Kansas 7. We'll be back with fourth quarter action after this message and a word from our local stations.
America Sports coverage of today's game is sponsored by Mazda and the full line of sophisticated Mazda products. Mr. Goodwrench and General Motors Parts. And by Miller High Life. Welcome to Miller Time.
Frank Herzog and Dennis Franklin at Lawrence, Kansas, where Tulsa leads 10-7 and trying to get seven more here on third and goal. Here's the pitch. It's Gunner. He's got room. I want to show you the replay on this, Dennis, because you're going to see a great block by the guy who may well be our MVP on the day, Ken Lacy. But the story right now is Tulsa's got the lead. They've upped it to 9. They can make it 10 with a successful conversion. Look at number 5, Ken Lacy out in front. Drive that man out, hold him a little, and get into the end zone.
That was the difference. And the other thing to point out was Gunner, number 22, just outran number 48, Arbanis.
The extra point is good. Tulsa has gone up by 10 points with a 25-yard drive that used 2.5 minutes and 7 plays.
Watch number 22, Michael Gunner. When he gets to pitch here, he shows great speed and gets a great block from Ken Lacy, number 5 out in front. You see it right there. He outruns 48 that just went by in your pitcher from Tulsa. I'm sorry.
They've got a 10-point lead. An up back for Kansas. On the return, and good field position at the 40.
6 points as quickly as possible.
Don Fambrough is worried. Both his wide receivers are flanked out here to the near side. Frank Sire on first and 10 from his own 39. Batted down.
Now everybody's looking at one another and wondering if we're going to get back into this football game, and they need something to happen that's successful.
Sire again on second down. He's got time. He's got a man. Russ Baston, the crossing batter. That'll be a first down. Kansas shows 14 and a half minutes left to go. They went with a blitz. He got it off to Kerwin Bell. Might be interference. Let's see. Let's find out from Robert McClintock. Holding. That's an automatic.
Holding on the defense. A 10-yard penalty. It's a first down.
Remaining. First and 10 at the 32-yard line of Tulsa. Tulsa has run 68 plays in the game so far. Kansas 43. Capers far side. Baston to the near. On the draw. Kerwin Bell tripped up. Came into this game completing 63% of his passes. He's way below that this afternoon. Picked off. Almost batted down. Defensive line
has got to be aware of Tulsa coming on a blitz or linebackers blitzing in this situation, third down and 7.
Capers and Green to the far side of the field. Going for Green. He makes the diving catch. He made the reception. He got it. He scooped it. Threatening at the 16. Kerwin Bell. Frank Sires, 8 for 18 today. 126 yards. He's thrown 2 interceptions. The blitz is on. Got his tight end. Down to the 5. Mark it at the 4. Sylvester Byrd. He had knocked the pass down. Knocked it out of Byrd's hands. He was surprised when Byrd turned upfield. First and goal. Wayne Capers has come back into the game. And two tight ends. Opposite Bell. Waving of the wheat.
You can say all you want about Kerwin Bell, but the guy that makes this play is Frank Sire, right there getting that pitch out. And because once he made that pitch, it was nothing for Kerwin to do but use his great speed and get the 6 points. That was just a great drive by Kansas, and they're back in this football.
And insist before it's all over, he'll kick a 60-yarder.
But it won't matter unless they make this 2-point
conversion. That's exactly right. Two receivers to the far side. Kerwin Bell.
Team play. Kerwin Bell comes out late after the block. And Sire does a great job of getting the ball to him. He runs for the corner of the end zone with his great speed. 2-point conversion for Kansas.
Well, we've got ourselves a football game, Dennis. 17-15. There it is. Tulsa leads 11-26 left to play. And if Tulsa is going to grind out that football game, they're going to have to do it now.
Well, you know, we talked about that at the beginning of the football game. The Kansas defense was the most important and critical part of the Kansas team's effort today. So they got to come out and stop Tulsa in this series if they want to win.
Phillips and May wait for the kick. It's May who will field the ball in the end zone and take it out. It's a touchback. Remaining. And there's the score. Critical time for Tulsa. They've got to come up with a sustained drive. Gunner. There was a hole. The scoring drive, 61 yards in 10 plays. Tom Freeze, the defensive captain for Kansas.
Possible, and I probably would have declined that.
Wide receivers to both sides of the field. First and 20. Ken Lacy, nowhere. Second and 19. Tulsa must move this ball out. Got a man. Left it short. David Hershey, the
to get a first down by running, and it's caused them to have to pass, which they don't do very well.
Going for Phillips. Robert Gentry on the... There's his average for the day. Kansas wants a return. High floater into the wind. Green takes the fair catch, and Kansas has excellent field position. First and 10 at the Tulsa 47-yard line. MVP winner for Kansas. It may very well be Kerwin Bell now. He seems to have given the Jayhawks the lift they needed here late in the game. It's Kerwin Bell with the ball. But, oh, that's tremendous. 8 yards to go. Wayne Capers, the Big 8 receiver on the near side. He goes the other way. Bob Johnson. Minutes left to go in the game. Kansas trails by two.
This is a situation where Kerwin Bell makes makes a big difference because you can fake to him as well as let him run the football.
He's going to run it. First down, Kansas. First down to play. The preliminary indication is holding. He had the first down yardage by a yard.
That really hurts Kansas. They've had momentum. They were moving the football. They can't afford to make these kind of mistakes.
A 10-yard holding penalty on the offense. They'll still be first down.
Simpson, come out and throw the ball maybe to Kerwin on a screen or a delay play.
There it is, Coach. You got it. He got 13. Key blocker on that screen. Second down and 8. Screens it out to E.J. Jones. Oh, did he take on that defensive player? Fourth quarter. On third and 5. Kerwin Bell.
And Kansas keeps the ball.
Called a money player, right? 7:40 left to play. First and 10, Kansas at the 23 of Tulsa. 3 yard gain for Bell. Second and 7.
Again here. In most instances thus far, he's gotten double coverage. Now he's got single.
Dino Bell is now the deep back. In for his brother. He's got the football. Tried to turn it out. Maybe should have turned it in. John Cooper ran.
Weak sider will throw a pass, but let him audible and put that offense in the best possible situation they can.
Bell dove for it, didn't get it. We've got a late flag after the play. He didn't make the 212 yards and a touchdown in that game for Georgia. Three wide receivers for Kansas. Third and 14. Bell on the delay, and no, Tulsa wouldn't let it happen. Bruce Kalmeyer to try to give Kansas the lead. Up. There's a return. Nate Harris, the flanker. What a big play for Tulsa.
Too much penetration by Tulsa on the left side of the line of scrimmage.
Almost got away. Nate Harris. minutes and 29 seconds. Skip asked the quarterback. Lacy to the 30. A dot for Kansas.
And try to cause Tulsa to lose yardage.
One wide receiver, two tight ends for Tulsa. Gunner. Look at him fight for the yardage. He's up. He made the tackle. Again, the clock runs. Wants to get that ball back. Third down. Asked. Adamay booted three consecutive runs from 60. He's kicking into the wind. 20 there. It's good. Tulsa has up the lead to 5. Good hold that time. His reaction.
Not much of one. It looks like he's very confident to me.
Underdog came in here, fell behind 7-0. 4:02 remain. It'll be Green. 2 yards deep. He wants to come out. Knocked out of bounds. Victory. Here from 20 yards further. Bruce comes out to the near side. Time now will run. Fourth time Sires had to tuck the ball. Kansas trails by 5, 20-15. Sire. Quick hitter over the middle to his tight end. Ernie Wright. The Kansas coaches believe that Ernie Wright, who's now going off the field limping there, can be the prototype tight end for them in the future. The problem, they say, is he's skinnier than he looks. They can't get weight on him. They've tried everything. Sire on 1st and 10. Picked off. Cliff Abbott, the linebacker. Big turnover.
The mistake here, Sire just doesn't see number 57, Abbott. And Tulsa was in an underneath coverage, a lot of zone, linebackers dropping off, and the only way to beat that really is to throw in front of them, and a lot of passes to the backside of the backfield. That time they tried to get. Tulsa's in the driver's seat now.
Third interception, that one by Cliff Abbott of Liberal, Kansas, one of the three Kansas players in this team. Asked, gets to the 30, a 3-yard gain. Is all Tulsa's. 3 minutes left to go. Last year, the Hall of Fame Bowl. Now they face 1-2-1 going into Big 8 play. They'll mark it at the 28 to bring up 3rd down and 5. On the other hand, what is the
doubt? There isn't any doubt now.
On 3rd and 5. The quick hitter to Lacy, and he's got the 1st down. The clock continues to move. It stopped now so they can move the chains, but Lacy will make sure the ball stays in Tulsa hands. Gentry and Coleman on the stop. Look at the deep.
You can't relax now.
1st and 10, Tulsa. It is 1st and 10 on the Lacy run. He has 159 yards on 28 carries and a touchdown today. While we have an opportunity, we'd like to say thank you to the people who were very helpful to us from these two schools. Sports Athletic Director and Head Coach John Cooper. Defensive Coordinator. Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from Tulsa today is Ken Lacy, who rushed for over 150 yards and a touchdown against Kansas. And the Chevrolet MVP from Kansas is Darren Green, who produced a 76-yard punt return for a touchdown. A check in the amount of one. Thank you to the warm people of Lawrence, Kansas, and the University of Kansas for their fine hospitality over the last 3 days. Athletic Director Jim Lessig, Sports Information Director Sid Wilson, and Head Coach Don Fambra. 2nd down. Asked on the carry inside the 10. He's very close. He'll produce 3rd down. Very much in control. 1 minute, 12 seconds left to play in this game. Tulsa leads Kansas by 5, 20 to 15. They face third down and two with the ball at the 9-yard line of the Jayhawks. Critical play here. If they can hold on to the ball and get close, they can at least walk away with a field goal. Ast keeps and gets to the 5. That's good for a first down. As soon as they move the chains, they'll start the clock. And the time is going to run out on the Jayhawks of Kansas unless they can come up with a miracle. That Tulsa sideline is alive.
You know, Frank, Skip Ash has done a great job this afternoon of making those split-second decisions. I mean, it's a very difficult thing to ask a youngster to come in and take control of an offensive team and make those split-second decisions on that are required on the veer option.
Yeah, he'll just take the loss rather than risk a penalty, and we got a flag on a late hit. Again, that will stay game today, especially for Tulsa.
That's true, and you got to give particular credit to that offensive line. Steve Cox, number 58, Sid Abramowitz, number 79.
He's had a great game, hasn't he?
Yes, David Iams, number 54.
We have a dead ball, personal foul on the defense.
A late hit. The pups can hunt. John Cooper's line. We got to find out if these young pups can hunt. Just falls on it. They'll take the 5-point win. The clock is moving. Kansas has no timeouts left. That's going to be the ball game. Four seconds. Three. You see it counting down. Tulsa has come up with its second consecutive big win. Oklahoma State 2 weeks ago, and Kansas here this afternoon. Tulsa 20, the Jayhawks 15. We'll be back with postgame in just a moment. Kane of Tulsa comes into Lawrence, Kansas, and gets an upset. They beat the Jayhawks. What was the key, Dennis?
I think the key was their offense. You know, we talked about it at the top of the game. They were able to run the type of offense that they know how to run, and that's that veer offense. Lacey had a tremendous day, a big day offensively for Tulsa, and Skip Ash just made the right decisions at the right time.
Tulsa wound up with 271 yards rushing. When you run the ball like that, you can waste a lot of clock. Tulsa, the happy victors. 's coverage of NCAA football will continue after this word from your local stations.
The NCAA Today is sponsored by Prudential. For life, health, auto, or home insurance, for your family's financial security, for peace of mind, get a piece of the rock. Prudential Insurance.
The Golden Hurricane of Tulsa whipped into Lawrence today and will whip out it with a 20-15 victory. On the sidelines with us, head coach John Cooper, who probably is the happiest man in this town right now. How about it, John?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If anybody's any happier than me, they're up there in the sky somewhere. I'm very happy, very, very proud of our football team. I thought we played a really sound ball game today on both sides of the ball. Our defense made the big play when they had to, blocking the field goal. And I tell you, I don't think there was any luck involved in blocking that field goal. We worked real hard on that. Nate Harris was a young man we had as a wide receiver last year, and we put him over as a defensive halfback this year and did a great job. And I can't say enough for this young man, Ken Lacey. I'm proud of the entire football team. To bring an underdog football team like we have at Tulsa into Lawrence, Kansas, and to beat a real good Big 8 football team like the University of Kansas obviously gives me a lot of satisfaction.
Coach, we're almost out of time, so give it to me real quickly. What was the one key in this game?
Oh, the one key play was a block field goal, no question about it. We were moving the football early in the game, but we weren't scoring any points, so the block field goal is far and away the big play in the ball game.
All right, Coach, congratulations and thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's it from Kansas. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports.